What is Legends doing? 2024 is already so crazy with these releases. Super Saiyan 2 Gohan and Universal Spirit Bomb GT Goku were both huge celebration headliners for Dokkan, and Legends is like monthly releases. We hope you guys like it. And speaking of liking things, I hope you guys have liked this video. So what else could Toshi and the Legends team be cooking for the rest of 2024? That's what we're here to figure out. Starting with just how many characters they have left to release. In 2023, we got 19 premium releases in the form of 6 Ultras and 13 Legends Limited characters, which was a huge increase in premium releases compared to the 2 previous years, because in 2021, Legends released 14 premium characters with 13 LFs and 1 Ultra, and in 2022, there was also 14 premium characters released with 10 LFs and 4 Ultras. So they somehow fit 5 more premium characters into 2023 compared to the 2 previous years, which is why I think we might see even more than 19 premium characters this year, especially since they've already released 4 premium characters right now at the beginning of March. And this time last year, we only had 3 with LF-17, Ultra Hit, and the LF Revival UI Goku. So we have an absolutely insane year to try and predict. And all these characters mean that I'm going to need a lot of Chrono Crystals, which is why I'm so incredibly excited to say today's video is sponsored by Under Night Embirth 2 System Celeste. Thank you, Arc System Works and Airdrop, for the sponsor today. And yes, I said Arc System Works. We talk about them a lot on this channel, and they're a part of the amazing people behind this game. So it's really cool to have them be a sponsor today. And just in case you're not familiar, Under Night Embirth 2 is a fighting game and the latest installment in the Uni series, where you'll witness the curtain fall in the Tale of the Hollow Knight.
But what else does it have?
Great visuals and a deep, robust battle system? Of course. An awesome roster of characters, including new ones to the series? Absolutely. Rollback netcode that makes for an actual good online experience in a fighting game? Yes, it's got it. Me still being bad, but also having an absolute blast while playing this? Yes, because this game feels great and landing combos is incredibly satisfying. Like right now, I'm playing as Yuzu. I gotta zone in, gotta zone up. All right, here we go. Ooh, look at that. Oh, with the grab. I mean, dude, look how cool this game looks. I gotta zone up, No. Oh. Yo, we actually took a round off of B rank. I am gonna take that as a win right now. Okay, I may have lost the set, but I'm still having fun, and I know you will too. So check out Under Night Embirth 2 by clicking my link down below in the description. It's available on, guess what, PS4, PS5, Steam, and Nintendo Switch. So thank you again to Arc System Works and Airdrop for sponsoring this video, and thank you guys for clicking the link and checking out Under Night Embirth 2 today. Now, we will be going month by month to try to predict these and actually placing characters in their time slots. However, before I even started doing that, I wanted to look at the massive omission of characters that we are still missing that need Legends Limited or Ultra versions, and then I started piecing them and placing them where they need to be, which I'll be giving future Nano a grading sheet to go by later in this video, so stay around for that. Now, that does bring us to March, and we did just get the announcement of Looming Nemesis, which is really cool that it's not just related to the sagas. Like, they can do something where we could get, I don't know, 2 Freezes or something related. Now, last year in March, we got the 1 Ultra, which was Rosé. This year, obviously, it could be an LF and an Ultra, but it could also be the same pattern we saw from January, where we get 2 LFs, because if they do a hard focus into LOE, then LOE needs help and needs the help in terms of like 2 Legends Limited characters, or at least 1 LF and 1 Ultra, which brings me to my guesses. And I do want to point this out. I made all this prior to even knowing that this is going to be the theme for this month, prior to knowing about the Zenkai, prior to knowing about the free-to-play Broly that we just got. So with Golden Frieza getting a Zenkai, with Broly getting a free-to-play unit, I do think the most deserving character in this time slot is going to be LF Golden Frieza from the Resurrection F film. Now, I definitely don't think he'd be the Ultra. I do think they would give him a Legends Limited first and then give him an Ultra, but that also isn't necessary, right? When you look at Ultra Broly or Ultra Janemba, these characters don't have Legends Limited. They're just straight up go, oop, here you go, here's an Ultra. But I do think that Frieza could easily be either an Ultra, because he has a sick intro going into Golden, or has a cool LF in terms of just literally destroying the planet, and they can definitely work with that. But I do hope it's Frieza. And then if we do get a second premium character and they pair it up with a Golden Frieza, it could either be an Ultra Full Power Frieza, because we just had a Namek celebration last year that we didn't get a Frieza for, right? We got the LF Namek Goku and there was no Frieza there. So it definitely could be a back-to-back Frieza release here. Now, if they don't go the Frieza route, there are a couple other characters that could obviously fit into this sort of campaign title. One of those being a character I cannot believe still does not have an LF to this day, which is Z Broly. Where is he at? It's insane that he doesn't have one. Then going back to LOE, because again, it does need Lineage of Evil, needs help. We already have an LF Final Form cooler, but we don't have an LF Metacooler. So would love to see him potentially here. And I do think that both of these, Z-Broly and Metacooler, have got to be within the next like 12 to 18 months of releases. I definitely think I would put money on seeing Z-Broly at some point this year. So he definitely could be here. And I think in terms of what they've titled it, and of course, what all these are choices I had prior to even knowing the campaign details, I think these are all prime choices right now to drop as we are on that build up to the anniversary. Now that does bring us to April. I think April could go a few routes. Again, this was a month last year we got an LF and an Ultra. This was the SSJ3 Goku. I'm laughing because anytime I think of this unit, I just think of Ryuden, and I think of how much like SSJ3 seems to get shafted in this game. So sorry, Rai. But we got the duo with the SSJ3 and SSJ2, and then we got Ultra Kid Buu. So they could repeat that. I think there could be a change up here. We'll talk about that more when we get to the anniversary section. But if they do repeat it and we do get an Ultra and an LF, I definitely think if they don't do Z Broly in March, he could also be here because we haven't had another Ultra Super Saiyan Goku since the free-to-play one launched. And this is definitely a very different Ultra Super Saiyan Goku because they could do some really cool stuff with his intro with the other characters giving him energy to finish off Broly. I'm talking, of course, Super Saiyan Goku from movie number 8, the introduction to Broly. I'm talking about a Super Saiyan Goku from that. So an LFC Broly with an Ultra Super Saiyan Goku is an easy setup, easy intro, easy ink art. Like, those are just things we haven't seen. Matter of fact, we kind of saw it with the Broly and Trunks unit in Dokkan. So it'd be cool to see something like that right here in April. If not that, I have two other choices I could see them going with. One would be a Battle of Gods Beerus paired up with a Battle of Gods Super Saiyan God Goku. I think that this, a celebration themed around this has to be somewhere, right? We haven't had a Beerus since, I mean, he was the technical first Legends Limited character. He didn't even come out with an LF, and they had to like make his LF later. And then also Super Saiyan God is still so underutilized that they could give us multiple Super Saiyan God units this year from like different sections, and it would be completely and totally okay. So I definitely think he could be somewhere. And then if not him, you know, something they haven't touched in a really long time is Saiyan Saga with Kaioken Goku. We have the LF Grade 8 Vegeta, but we don't have the Kaioken Goku to pair with it as an LF. So this could be a month where they decide to go, hey, we're about to be an anniversary, but here is a Saiyan Saga Kaioken Goku. So those are my April choices. I left those a little bare so I could put some more choices later in the calendar year, starting with the anniversary. Here's the switch up that I think is highly possible, and that is that they actually start with an Ultra. Yes, I think this could be the switch up that we see, and we still get two LFs, but it's two LFs in the middle. So we would get an Ultra into two LFs into another Ultra. I absolutely think this is a possible thing that we see. And here's where we begin my true agenda for this prediction. I want you guys to take a look at your list of Legends Limited right now and take a look at who needs Zenkais. Oh, that's right. Dragon Ball Super Broly, Dragon Ball Super Broly Gogeta Blue, and the Dragon Ball Super Broly Tag Switch Blues. All three have had characters all around them get Zenkais, but they haven't been touched. I wonder why. Could it be that Toshi and the Legends team is obviously saving? These are high profile Zenkais. These are Zenkais people want badly, especially given the fact that the Blue Boys are the first ever Tag Switch character in the game. They are saving these guys for something huge. And I think that when they want to do these, they want to make it themed and make it make sense. So in this case, and because for whatever reason, these games do somehow align releases, whether on purpose or not, Dokkan just had a massive Dragon Ball Super Broly drop for the 9th anniversary on JP. So it would not surprise me in the slightest if we start the anniversary with our first ever, because this would be very fitting, we get our first ever Zenkai for a tag switch and our first ever Ultra tag switch unit. Now, what's the difference here? Oh, that's right. We don't have the gods represented in this game really at all, right? The only versions of the just standard Super Saiyan gods in this game are not LFs, they're not Ultras, and they haven't been released in literal years, right? So I think the cool thing you could do here, and what I think I'm actually doing with the thumbnail, is Super Saiyan gods. Straight up, just you make them Super Saiyan gods, you make the first ever Ultra tag switch, and then you also go, boom, guess what, guys? We're Zenkaiing the tag switch blues as well. So now you can run this cool new shiny Ultra tag unit with your newly Zenkai tag Blue Boys. And they've been cooking with the Zenkais lately. At least as of filming this, the Zenkais, even from the non-LFs, there's all the Zenkais lately have been really, really viable and really, really good. So I have to imagine that when they give that nice little extra bit of spice to those tagged Blue Boys from maybe my favorite celebration of all time, Fest 2021. I mean, I really like 5th Anniversary. I really like Fest of this last year. But that one, that 2021 Fest with those Tag Blue Boys is one of my favorites. Now, if they don't go this route or they're potentially saving the Broly stuff for maybe later in the anniversary, I still believe DBS Broly is involved in the anniversary somehow, then I could also see them starting the anniversary with an Ultra Super Saiyan 4 Goku. When you take a look at the landscape of GT, the available characters in GT that could either be an Ultra or Legends Limited, there's not that many, right? In terms of villains, you basically have three: Baby, Omega, Super 17. Well, guess what? We've already gotten Super 17, so he's off the list. In terms of heroes, realistically, you have four. You have Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta, Super Saiyan 4 Vegeta, Super Saiyan 4 Goku. You can do his variants between full power and base, but still, it's basically the same character. And then you have the Universal Spirit Bomb Goku, which we also have already gotten, so take him off the list. So I do think GT shows up somewhere in this anniversary, and maybe multiple times, but I could see them starting it with this huge Ultra Super Saiyan 4 Goku, because he's already had a standard LF. He's already had a tag switch LF. So the next level of giving Goku like this new unit, Super Saiyan 4 Goku specifically, would be making him an Ultra. Now, to cover my bases here, I also think it is possible they don't go the Ultra route and they just do something unique with LF tag gods, right? I still think there are plenty of new unique mechanics that we have yet to see in this game. One of those being fusion. We haven't seen an in-game fusion at all. People always question how they could do that. Pretty easy. They could do it literally with the gods if they wanted to. They could technically make the gods transform when you fill up their unique gauge, or they could make them in the first ever. Would that be the first ever transforming tag duo? That'd be kind of cool. Or they just fuse when their unique gauge fills up. Boom, fusion in-game. It's done. So I definitely think we're going to see some new stuff in the form of that. So if they don't go with ultra gods, then I can see them doing an LF gods that somehow fuse into Gogeta or our first transforming unit, or something unique with them in some form. Now that brings us to the part two of the anniversary, which last year blew everyone's expectations for the anniversary out of the water. No one could have thought we were getting a fake out into getting the Gammas on top of Orange Piccolo. That was crazy. So I think they follow that up and they do give us two characters here, two LFs. And I also think because they've now introduced this game original, which by the way, I think will be still semi grounded here. I think we could see some sort of game original here. I think this could be where Broly is involved. I think we could see some sort of LF original that pairs Broly up with another character like Goku or something of that nature. I also think this might be where some of the GT representation is, so that way they can squeeze in like an LF Omega or an LF Super Saiyan 4 Vegeta, or even an LF Super Baby 2 could be here, and some of these could be paired as well. If they go the DBS Broly route and this is where DBS Broly shows up, they could 100% do our first ever sort of transforming DBS Broly that goes from, say, like base, and maybe he goes into Super Saiyan, or he goes from Super Saiyan into full power but as a Legends Limited, because we have that, but it's in the form of the purple unit that'll be 6 years old this year. Oh my gosh, dude, that unit will be 6 years old this December. That's crazy. And if somehow the gods or a variant of Gogeta from the Dragon Ball Super Broly did not show up in part one, I think we could definitely see him in part two. And I'm very confident that Broly or GT will be the main meat of the anniversary, that I'm gonna actually leave my choices at just that. And I think DBS Broly being somewhere in the theme for the anniversary is even stronger now, besides all the Zenkai stuff I just mentioned, but also the free Broly we just got. Like, I think they are absolutely building to a massive Dragon Ball Super Broly themed anniversary. And I know they don't say like it's truly on theme. Like last year we got Tournament of Power into superhero into future, but I do think there will be a section of this anniversary that will be super heavily themed around DBS Broly. And we're gonna move on to the ultra of the anniversary, the main ultra. Now I will say, and I know we've been talking about this for a long time, I do think Legends Limited will be applied to ultras at some point this year. I do think that is highly possible. When looking at the roster, there are some massive omissions, but I do think they're looking to maybe take it up another level. Like, I do think at some point we will see another level, and anyone that says we won't see Legends Limited ultras, I still think you're crazy. They're gonna add that nice little extra layer that they can then revisit some of these characters and give them new LFs and prettier LFs and revamped models and revamped this and different camera angles and all of that. Because at the end of the day, sometimes you guys will throw out characters that you think should have LFs and think should have ultras, but I think this game does cost a lot to dev for, whether you want to believe it or not. And I think at the end of the day that they don't want to spend the money on some of these characters because they know they won't get it back. It is a gacha game. Some of these characters just aren't to the level that they want them to be in terms of popular with the fan base. And so they've got to retread some of the characters we've seen before. And the only way to retread them and make them interesting is to add a new unique twist, like with the gods, maybe giving them the ability again to transform. We haven't seen that with a tag yet, or fuse, or in this case, make ultras now have an LF and then they can revisit them. But they might save that for Fest. I will say it is highly possible that they save the Legends Limited version of this until Fest, or maybe even 7th anniversary. But I do think it is within the next like year-ish so of this game where we start seeing LL
Ultras. Before my choices here, Ultra DBS Broly. If somehow it starts as DBS Broly related and he doesn't show up anywhere except for as a Zenkai, he might finish it off because I do think he's absolutely worthy of being the anniversary, super crazy, end of anniversary Ultra. If not him, the obvious one, Ultra Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta, because he's somewhere this year, whether he's here or he's in Legends Fest. He is somewhere this year for sure. I feel like that is a guaranteed. And this is the crazy one, and I think this might throw people off. If Ultra Super Saiyan 4 Goku doesn't show up as, say, the part one, I think it could be here. Well, this is where everyone would be assuming, especially if it's been a lot of GT. This is where the Gogeta would show up. But what if he doesn't show up here and instead is saved for Legends Fest? And to build up the GT tag more and to build up more hype for the GT tag, they give us the Ultra Super Saiyan 4 Goku right here. I think Super Saiyan 4 Goku by himself, by the way, is easily hype enough to be the actual anniversary Ultra. If there is just one singular Ultra in the entire anniversary, I personally believe that. I know a lot of people probably would rather it be Gogeta, but my guess, again, if he isn't here, don't lose your minds. He will be the end of year character. And it is also possible that my sort of whole Legends Limited spill could be saved for him to finish off the entire year and they introduce it as the like finale character of 2024. Now that moves us on to the next LF, because if you guys remember last year, we got an LF following anniversary, but in the same month as the Ultra Vegito Blue. So this is probably a good spot for them to throw a semi-hype character, because I mean, it was Cell, I think, and he ended up being really good, and androids have continued to just get better and better and better over time. I think this could be a Legends Limited Kefla, Legends Limited Hit, or if they don't do a full DB Saga theme celebration at some point this year, possibly an LFDKP. I do think he could be somewhere, and I think that it would be semi-smart to sandwich him between what is obviously massive anniversary, massive, you know, sales from the anniversary. And then you're kind of like, this is a little bit of a cool down. You know, they did an LF sell that was, it was pretty chill last year. This could be an LF DKP. But it is crazy that Kefla has had no real, like, Legends Limited or Ultra representation in this game. And also crazy that Hit does have an Ultra, but he doesn't have an LF. And he is absolutely, like, an LF level character. Now, that brings us to August. So, here in August, there should just be one LF. And I actually don't see an uptick here. I think this will stay pretty similar to how we would have seen it before. So in August, if somehow we still haven't gotten a Z Broly, which I know earlier I paired him with a Super Saiyan Goku, and I feel like I gave a pretty good reasoning as to why we could get another Ultra Super Saiyan Goku. If they decide to keep him as a solo unit and they are still ramping up pre-anniversary and still pumping out tons of different units, and they want to give Broly his single solo monk, it could be here. So this could be Z Broly if we haven't seen him yet. Another one we could see, and again, speaking of Broly, would be a Tag Goten and Gohan. This is a character that obviously has been in Dokkan for like 5 years, and we haven't actually seen represented over here basically at all. And so it'd be really cool to get like a true, I know that there's the LF Goten that does the sort of like Family Kamehameha, but like a true Family Kamehameha LF is not in this game. So got it in Fighters, we got it in basically everything. So bring it over here in this game. And that could be another one, since there's already an Ultra Broly. There's not really a pairing for that unless it's like a double LF month. So this could be another really good one. And then two more options here. To piggyback off of what I just said last month, I fully believe Kefla is somewhere. And Tournament of Power will still be in this year. So I do think Kefla could also be a really good solo area. She might be paired with an Ultra, like an Ultra Hit or something, but she could also be a solid solo release. And I do feel like August is not a month for like total crazy hype. I know last year it was Namek Goku, and that was a really hype release, but I think August is one of those where it's like hype, but it's not like just insane, let's zap you of all your CC hype. And with that said though, if somehow the anniversary does not touch on Super Saiyan God Vegeta, I figure it will if it does anything with Broly, a solo Super Saiyan God Vegeta could be really, really sick. Now I'd almost rather see him as an Ultra, but he could absolutely be an LF right here. That then brings us to September. So this is an interesting one, okay? This is where we are getting really, really close to Daima. Now I don't think it'll start in September. I'm guessing Daima starts in October. And so September, I do think this is a month where in 2023, we actually only got one LF. That was the Path to Power Kid Goku. And they definitely could 100% revisit DB here, and we could get, say, an LF actual from the series Kid Goku that does his like punch through DKP as an LF, and they pair that up with an Ultra DKP, because I do think we could see an Ultra DKP. However, if they don't go that route, you know what, I haven't really mentioned this year yet, which could, by the way, be in March. There definitely could be something in March for this, is a Tag Rose and Zamasu. Now, the only reason why I didn't want to put this in March is because Rose was literally last March. Would it surprise me? No. Are they a nemesis? I would kind of consider them that. I think the March thing is more for Frieza, but people are asking for a Tag Rose and Zamasu, and they could be Legends Fest level. They really could, but they could also be right here in September, a Tag Rose and Zamasu, and then picture this, they pair that with an Ultra Trunks. Now, we've already had an LF Trunks. That LF, by the way, I rewatched it. I need to rate that LF higher. That LF is so sick. I'm using him a little bit on some teams. Again, his LF is awesome. So I don't think they can revisit that. I don't know what they would do better with it, but they definitely could do it as like an intro, and he has like his big sword to like fight around with. I don't know why I did it like that, but you know what I'm saying. So that could be one pairing. And another one I would love to see, a pairing I would love to see. Okay, picture this. Hear me out. LF Buhan, because his representation in this game is like next to nothing. If Kid Buu, in my opinion, could get an Ultra, then Buhan can get an LF. Okay, Buhan is sick. I'm sorry, he is. And they could maybe do it with Super Buu, and he has some sort of cool mechanic that gets him into like Buhan or something, however it might be. But then they pair that with Ultra Majin Vegeta. You knew he'd be on the list somewhere. You knew. There's no way. I'm trying to manifest Ultra Majin Vegeta into this game so badly. Please, Toshi. Please, Legends team. Please let me see an Ultra MV sometime this year. Vegeta Clan is still going to need the help. That's why I keep working Vegeta Clan into these different months, because I do think Vegeta Clan is going to get stuff throughout the rest of this year. He'll definitely get stuff through the use of being a tag character, but I want to see some like solo stuff, you know, and make it better than Super Vegeta. Now that does bring us to October. Now October was a cool thing last year because they actually swapped it. They gave us the Ultra first and then still gave us an LF. Now my presumption is that this is when Daima will launch. And what is crazy about Legends is that Legends has never had a series ongoing with it. If you guys don't remember, Legends started a few months after Dragon Ball Super ended. And so Legends has had DBS Broly, which it launched a DBS Broly same day that DBS Broly launched in Japan. You know, we got the Gammas like a few months before it came out, or a couple months before it came out in Japan, the superhero movie, and 5 months before it came out in the States. So Legends has always been on top of doing these collabs with the films, but for the first time in the history of the game, we'll have an ongoing series. So I do presume that Daima will have a character. Now, Daima probably will get a Legends Limited or an Ultra or both at some point, but probably not coinciding with the release, because I don't figure the big stuff, the crazy stuff that we'll probably see in Daima at some point will happen until probably towards the end, and they won't spoil through the game. So it'll probably just be like a standard Mega Rising or just a collab banner that's just a bunch of SPs with like Kid Vegeta, Kid Goku, Kid Roshi, stuff like that. But they will still have premium format banners like LFs and potentially Ultras. And so in this month, I definitely think we could see some different pairings. One of these is, I'm coming back, if Metacooler didn't launch for March, I do think this could be the month where we see Metacooler and say like a Super Saiyan Goku and Vegeta. Because I don't think that Super Saiyan Goku and Vegeta from that Cooler film is really Legends Fest. Okay, I think it's Legends Fest worthy, but I don't know if Legends thinks it's Legends Fest worthy. So we could see that pairing here. If not them, then I definitely think we could see an LF Cooler and Frieza. Now, I would love to see this during Anniversary or Fest, but if I'm going to put them somewhere, I'm putting them here, I think. And I do think that that is a what if that we could absolutely see, right? Like, it's a what if, but it's a very believable what if. And the thing with the what ifs in these games is they definitely want to have like a story behind it that they can set it up and make it make sense in the game. And making Cooler show up to fight with Frieza is probably the easiest story to write for the Legends team ever. So I definitely could see that. And that would be if it is just a solo LF month, because tag characters are pretty intense, right? That is absolutely something you could see being like a solo LF month. And then because they would have the diamond drop, and I know this sounds crazy, but they could also do Super Android 13. They really seem to like androids this year so far. So I definitely think Super Android 13 could definitely be on the calendar list for this year. And then if not him, but similar and piggybacking off of what Dokkan just did a few months ago, we could see our first like maybe tag unit with an assist character, or our first trio unit that maybe is like, let's say they're like purple and green, okay? I'm just throwing this out there. Let's say like purple and green, and they swap between like purple and green, but two of the characters are purple and one is green. So you're like constantly rotating through them. And so it's like Goku can swap into Vegeta, Vegeta can swap into Trunks, and Trunks can then swap back into Vegeta. And then, I don't know, somehow it's a trio switch character we've never seen before. This probably sounds a little more Legends Fest worthy or Anniversary worthy, but at the same time, I'm not sure if the Android 13 movie is hype enough to the Legends team to put that into a fest. The mechanic of it, of our first ever trio character, sounds like it would be, but then I don't know if the source material feels worthy enough. I don't know. I just had this idea and I wanted to put it somewhere on the list. And so I figured if they go solo this month, well, some of these could be Ultras too, but if they go solo this month with a big diamond release, then the solo could just be one LF with a diamond drop. Now that brings us to November, which is the beginning of Legends Fest, which last year they did dual LF drops, right? With Evil Kid and Beast. I do think that that will probably be back here, but I'm putting some big bet on new mechanics here. Like, this will really ruin my list. Again, trying to predict Legends Fest this early is crazy, by the way. But I do think they stick with some form of Goku and Vegeta here. I also think That in-game fusion is the next step, the next level. I think they will figure that out. I think they've been holding it back because, again, I think they're smart about how they drop stuff, right? Diddy and I had this whole discussion recently about how Dokkan is really just kind of been just having to retread so much lately because they did so much so fast. They've made LR sort of the standard, like TURs and Dokkan, which is like they've made those feel almost not unrunnable, but just real basic compared to their LR counterpart. And so they've done a really good job. Legends has done a really good job at pacing the release of Ultras here. So I do think if Anniversary starts with an Ultra, this could also be an Ultra time slot. But the mechanic I'm really hinging this on is the fact that I do think Fusion could be here because we've not had something that's been truly game-changing. There's been some cool mechanics and some cool little, like, quirks to characters, but nothing on the level of Tag Switch. And I'm not saying that this would even be to the level of Tag Switch, but in-game fusing is a huge mechanic missing from this game, a huge mechanic that we expect in most Dragon Ball games that this game does not have. Again, they could do it through a unique gauge. They could do it through main. There's a lot of ways they could do it. And so I definitely think, by the way, they will drip this, so it will start probably with Super Saiyan. So it could be a Super Saiyan Goku and Vegeta. They could variation them and make one like an angel that goes into angel version that goes into Gogeta, normal version that goes into Vegito, stuff like that. If they don't go that route, and if somehow Gogeta, Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta hasn't shown up before, he could also be here as a brand new, like crazy new mechanic that is Super Saiyan 4s that fuse into Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta, which is then also buff the GT tag. So I do think something related to obviously Goku and Vegeta being here, whether they're Super Saiyans or they're fours, but I do think they hold back and they don't go immediately into blues because I do think blues being the newest hold maybe the most hype to the general fandom. And I think they'll hold back on those and release those later. So I think if you debut this new fusion mechanic, it will be for Super Saiyans into Vegito, Gogeta, or they go the GT route to keep buffing GT if Gogeta hasn't shown up somewhere before from GT. And here is how Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta possibly shows up. Now that brings us into December, the final month of the year. Start off with the LF. I think we could see another game original here. I mentioned it before, but let's take it a different step, right? I do think Broly could also be a part of the LF because I think he kind of sort of makes sense. Again, Dokkan did it with Trunks. They could maybe do Broly with, say, Shallot, or they could do Shallot with Goku. I think that this game very much so is trying to teeter around selling us the game characters like Zaha and Shallot and, Shallot and Shallot, the fusion one. And so I definitely think like either Shallot and Goku could be together, or they could put Shallot with Gogeta as like a character together. You know, I definitely think that the next game original, if not something like Cooler and Frieza or not something like Broly with Goku, then they could include some of the game original characters. But I think if they do that, they know their two most popular are, again, I hate that they're, it's too, and especially the way I talk, it's too close, but Shallot, the non-fused one, and Shallot. I swear that sounded the same. The fused version, and they could probably put fusions with fusions and Shallot with Goku. And they could be base, Super Saiyan, blues, you name it. But I definitely, we could see that here. And then to finish out the year, I still feel so confident that Legends Limited will be tagged on the Ultra to finish out Legends Fest. If not during the anniversary, for sure to finish out Legends Fest. And I feel like there are only like really three characters that could probably really pull that off and really be the debut for that. And I don't think they go back to say Gogeta Blue or VB here, because I feel like those are still semi-new. And although this would feel a little retreaded, I do think Mastered Ultra Instinct has not been touched since 4th anniversary. That'll be 2 years ago now, which is crazy. So he could be the headliner for that. I do think, and I know this sounds crazy to a lot of people, Beast could actually come back and be yet again here, because I do think Superhero will be a little dry moving throughout this year. I don't think we see Superhero again for a minute. Could be wrong. I didn't hedge any bets on that, as you just saw throughout the entirety of this video. So I do think Beast could finish out the year. And if not him, and if we've seen him nowhere else, then I think it is a definitive no questions asked Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta release, whether it be Ultra or Ultra Legends Limited, he will be this time slot. If he's not shown up anywhere else and we're looking on like December 20th and it's about to be reveals and stuff, I would put so much money that that reveal would be for Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta. It's not even funny. He is in this year. There's just no way you go to the GT tag, you want to buff the GT tag up, and you don't include him. Now for future Nano. Did I get a character right? Did I get it placed in the right month? Did I get its typing right? Which I know is a little all over the place, but if I said it, it's fine. Did I get the tag right? And then the final point to give me full 5 points here. Did I actually get the form right? Because there's a lot of form spitting out here as well. So that'll be for future Nano to figure out a year from now. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And I also want to give a massive shout out to Daredrop and Arc System Works for sponsoring this video. You guys can go pick up under my import too by clicking my link down below in the description. And if you want more Legends content, just click right here. I know you're gonna love it. I'll see you over there in that one. Bye.